Hello, this is Errol at home, and welcome to the making of V's afternoon hot chocolate soap. I infused 20 grams of cassia in 350 grams of olive oil for 3 months in the hot water cupboard for a subtle addition to the scent. I decided to master batch the oils for the remaining BTS in the soap series, pre-mixing all of the oils except for the olive oil in advance. I'll put the quantities and the recipe in the description box. This is a small batch I'm colouring with olive oil, which has been infused with indigo powder and then filtered because I wanted to make pink marshmallow heart embeds. I'm using chilled water to reduce the fumes when the lye dissolves and soaping with a 5% superfat. Please remember safe lye handling. Wear goggles, gloves, closed-toe shoes and long clothes, working in a well-ventilated area away from children and pets. The lye and oils need to be within 10 degrees of each other before mixing together. With this percentage of beeswax, the oils need to be kept about 50 to 55 degrees Celsius in order to remain fluid. The batter needs to be emulsified but still remain fluid enough to pour into the molds. So with this tiny batch, the milk frother is better than the stick blender. The batter hasn't reached trace yet, but the oil and water are not separating, so it has reached emulsification. I covered the soap with baking paper to prevent soda ash and put it into the freezer to harden it fast. This turned out to be a mistake. This larger batch is for the main body of the soap, and this is where the cassia-infused olive oil is being used. I'm adding sugar to improve the bubbles and cocoa to colour the batter. These are dissolved in hot water. All of the soaps in this series of BTS in the soap includes lavender essential oil because lavender equals purple. And in this bar, it's blended with cinnamon essential oil too. I put in 2 teaspoons of kale and clay to help anchor the scent and to improve the lather. And I also added some Peru balsam. I've tried various ways of adding this to soaps, and I've found the best way for me is to dissolve it in an equal weight of isopropyl alcohol. This way, it disperses better through the soap batter. Along with using cocoa and sugar, I wanted to use milk in the soap for authenticity. The sugar in the milk and the milk fat improves the lather and adds to the creaminess in the soap. When using milk, it's best to freeze it first. That way it tends not to scorch and smell bad when the lye is added. After a few hours in the freezer, the hearts were hard enough to pop out. The oils are at 55 degrees Celsius. I ended up having to put the lye solution into a bowl of hot water to get it up to temperature, and it turned bright yellow. I tried to filter it into the oils, but the cream made it too thick, so I gave up and just poured it in. Beeswax soap traces fast, and soaping at higher temperatures also speeds up saponification, so I hand-stirred and used the milk frother to combine the oils and lye before separating the batter into the different colorants. Peru balsam discolours the batter, so it was added along with the essential oils to the cocoa-coloured portion. The mould was marked along the cutting lines to help me line up the embeds, and even though I'd been sparing with the stick blender, the batter had still reached light trace by the end of the pour. It was still fluid enough to give a fairly flat surface. The milk had made the batter so yellow that adding the honey made no discernible difference to the colour at this point. The uncoloured portion of the batter was stick blended because I wanted it to be textured like a dollop of cream on top of the cocoa. The first layer has set just enough to start the second pour now. Using the spatula helps to slow the pour and stop the batter from breaking through into the cocoa layer underneath. Even though this layer was quite fluid at the start, by the time I'd finished it had reached thick trace. I had previously made another batch of cocoa soap for these flake embeds, using slightly less cocoa and pouring the soap in a 1 centimeter layer. Once it had hardened, I scored the top and bottom with a fork, then cut it into 3 centimeter strips to look like flakes. The honey-coloured batter needed to be kept fairly fluid to create a caramel drizzle over the top. It was then spritzed with isopropyl alcohol to reduce soda ash, and sprinkled with cocoa powder before placing the pink marshmallow hearts. Freezing the hearts too soon after pouring them turned out to be a mistake because once they thawed, they became too soft to handle without distorting. I put them back into the freezer briefly, but if I do this again, I'll make the embeds at least 24 hours ahead next time. This soap took 3 months to get to this point, and it still needs to cure for another month. If you live in New Zealand and would like a gift of this soap collection, I'll tell you how in the description. Stay well.